for soul. You know, and much study is the weirdness of the flesh. Now, one brother came up here and said I'm into Buddhism,
Hindu.
He named everything, bro.
But he didn't really know me. That's what I don't like. I'm like saying I'm into this, I'm leaving everything. I don't know. I mean, you don't really know.
This is the only book. And this book gives you the blueprint how to go through those other books and get meat out of it, get information out of it there and there, just prove certain things. That don't mean this book should be made for all this.
Like it says, it certainly sounds better than every other book.
Yeah, oh, that's right. It's a manly book, man.
You ever try to go read some of the scriptures out like, I ain't never seen nobody out reading the Egyptian scriptures, lifting people up there.
There is no definition.
It don't even make sense when you read.
There's nothing in them books, man. There's nothing in them books that talk about UFOs, Lord being lifted up into chariots, or no nuclear missiles.
No prophecies.
You know? Superman. Me and flying. This book goes forward. You know?
That's why, hey, that's why the Bible is like, it caused more controversy than anything else. It gets people mad, they want to kill you. Like these people, they pretty much wanted to kill us.
Yeah, for sure.
They wanted to kill us, out here. One dude was coming up, why y'all out here like that, though?
I mean, y'all had a kudos one, for real. You talking the nation of Israel, Israelites, man, they disrespect the hell out of
this man. This is terrible, man.
We'll talk.
You can't even say one word. You can't even have a question.
Yeah.
One question.
Really?
Yeah. I'm evil because I have a question. I just want to know.
Yeah,
no,
right.
Evil. Question.
Let me show you a question.
I know I couldn't ask God no question.
Right, right.
How was
well,
you
where
born?
You are?
You ain't going to learn without asking questions.
I don't even disagree with you.
Now, some people ask too many questions.
So do you believe
that the people are wrong? I don't know.
I said, I'm just saying, I don't know. I'm not going to just make me know now, just because you want me to say something.
I like it, bro. We like to kick it and just talk about it, you know what I'm saying? We enjoy talking about it. I love talking about it.
Teachers, or all workers of miracles?
Yeah, we can pull twice as hard back out of crazy as hell, yeah. Ain't nobody here knows. That's just gonna leave.
Well, that's what I was on. I was thinking about that. You know what I'm saying? That's the trick that they got.
Okay, African, you know what I mean?
That's the truth.
Yeah, but there's, because you do got heathen, you got a lot of Israelites in Africa. Yeah, of course.
Yeah, every race is like, it's heathen.
But part of the secret, though, is actually
all of the black men, like all black people stupid, all black people practice, all black people play basketball.
Yeah, I'm going to
trick. The trick is, because every black people is thinking about that. But
that's
the worst thing about it, you got Nelson Mandela.
But Nelson Mandela
was a freedom fighter, though.
Well, he's a communist.
Who? He's a freedom
fighter. No, he's a communist.
Who?
Nelson Mandela was a
communist. But Nelson Mandela was not.
When he came over, he's an awful person. When he came over, listen, bro. When he came here, when he came out of prison, they brought him here and put a temporary parade for him. He said on national television, I'm not here for your Negroes. Yep. I'm here for my people. Yep. That's what Nelson Mandela said. The video's on the interview on YouTube, you can see it. He said, I'm not here for your Negroes. I'm here for my people. This was during the 90s. This is during the 90s, right. He's a heathen, man. He ain't our people. He ain't our people.
I don't know.
He's a heathen.
He had the same fight as me, so
anybody
he was fighting for his people. Bro.
Anybody who the mainstream media tells you is a great hero,
you could have said that about Malcolm X.
The media demonizes Malcolm X, though.
Of course.
They demonize
him.
But Malcolm X is actually probably the most intelligent of the bunch of all those. You know what I mean? He was smarter than Martin. He was definitely smarter than Nelson Mandela. And they demonize him. Spoke intelligently. Never cursed.
Attacked.
Yeah.
Any black man that's
they said all the biggest cut custom
right now is
out of mouth.
Did you listen to the Abitation?
I got down with this.
Yeah, I'm just glad you ain't got Marcus Garvey down there like that.
Marcus Garvey. But they worship, they say he was a prophet down there.
Marcus Garvey.
Mayor Coleman's a Freemason.
They call you brothers. Ain't no white Masons to call a white man brother ever.
But you know Mayor Coleman? You're right. In secret, they gonna turn their backs on
flat out.
Mayor Coleman's a Mason. Glover. Who's the other one that was down there?
Flat out.
That's on the King's building. That's what's going on. Over at the King's building. Right there.
You gotta go down there and check it out. They got all their pictures up.
What they did, I looked it up, they went to Ireland, you know what I'm saying, and then they got their masonry shit from there, but they wouldn't be recognized like any other Masons.
That's a York right.
Scotland ain't even recognized.
That's a York right. And actually, that's a York right brand of Freemasonry down there. That's part of that. Because you go down there, we know that, like, in the back of their mind, the so-called white man, Esau, he's not accepted as a brother. But probably they do let him in there just because to give a better appearance.
That's what I'm trying to tell people like that. Yeah. They think that the Masonation Private Nation actually free states and never free states. Never happened. No, it's still.
Emancipation right means a transfer of ownership.
It was some shit.
I thought it was going to transfer to you.
Yeah, it means emancipate. It means a transfer. Transfer ownership one to another. See, yeah, because if they freed them, freed the slaves, it would be called the Liberation Proclamation. The liberty is freedom.
And it's still in the bill that they still, like, half of the land.
It still exists.
not too clear. It's still there. It never got written.
Yes, it does. It's in the.
They can't do it.
Get up here in time.
You can't teach something
no way. Most people are there. I'm just like, be wrong, be right at the same time. The universe might be expanding, it might be staying expanding. Bouncing off other universes.
I need to
say what? Oh, yeah.
That's too simple. You're still talking about
that. Hey, where, yeah, you brought out that Nation of the Code. He didn't even look at it.
That's what I wanted to talk about. That's what I was talking about last time. Where the racist came from. This is all based on Moses. And this is everything.
Manoah, actually. Moses. Well, mainly Noah, because when Noah came out the ark, you had him sitting with Jack.
Because you might be the main. It is Noah. And then, you're right, it is Noah because. That's what I'm talking about. You already know because one, the whole thing came around about the Bible and got so demonized that his sons came in backwards. He saw him, his sons came in backwards. But ever since then, they used
that was Canaan. They was all black. Noah was black.
They wasn't.
All of his sons.
I don't know.
Yeah, but that's what the Christians.
That's what they use it. They use Christians black people to demonize black people. With that ever since.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what it's so called.
That's what maybe real. That's what they use. That's what they use.
But when you get to the scriptures, it don't make no sense. Just check
black,
this out.
Ever since then, the black people have been cursed.
Now check this out, though. We can just prove that because what is he had three sons: Ham, Shem, and Japheth. Now Ham, what does that mean? Ham comes from really it's calm, and it means heart or even hot, something like that. And it's referring to the complexion of the Hamites. So if they and we know the Hamites are black. The Hamites had a children called a Cush. That's where the Cushites come from, the Ethiopians. So if we know what they look like, they still call themselves by their original name to this day. So if they was dark skinned, what color would his brothers be? That, you know, it doesn't make sense.
I don't
know.
That's what the Christians say.
That you,
and then they give you this image.
Well, actually, that's
Russian. That came from Russia. They never gonna stop doing that. That's about it. That's why you're never gonna see a superhero, like a superhero, anything like that.
Luke Cage is a big new series.
Yeah, okay. Luke Cage is Iron Fist.
But that's really good.
That's
nice
too.
That
bad,
image is a woman.
It's bad.
That's the Mona Lisa.
They gonna bring it together eventually.
That's what that really is. People don't understand.
I was just reading about that a couple days ago.
That's what that really is.
You talking about
Luke Cage and Iron Fist?
You don't know that.
You saw when they made Hancock. They made him a clown. They made him like a CPO with power that destroyed the whole earth. They made him lock himself up in prison.
Yeah, prison. He has some power fan
prison.
Hancock with Will Smith, that movie.
Oh, yeah. See that?
The movie started off good.
When they make a black superhero, they gotta make him something stupid or something.
Yeah, they gotta make him crazy.
You know, they made him a faggot. You know, cause he put one head up with one dude's head in prison, or he said something about his own. So I can't remember. I ain't watched it so long. Yeah.
All them movies like that.
That's crazy. That's true.
Something
about that. Oh, I know. Y'all still going up north, moving up north?
Yeah.
I heard that Amazon, boy, they got some overtime for you, 12 hours.
That's what I heard, but I'm feeling those.
Yeah, they said they still have 5,000 positions.
I might just do
it. 12 hours too?
Hell yeah.
That's still
keep you alive, dog.
I want it. The longer shifts, the better. Dude. More days off a week.
Keep you healthy, dude.
Yeah. I don't know.
Tell your girl, man, she can take advantage of that system. Maybe you're
a criminal. I can't wait.
Right? I'm
smarter than that. That's what the motherfucker, they just built up that institution. I will though.
That's why they know that they can build their own army.
That's how it's going. It's in the Epic of Gilgamesh. That's where that story is. That just proves, just further proves there was a flood.
I never doubt the Bible.
They got their own version of the story, just like the Bible has the true account of it.
And you already know Pan was a foul fool when he put him in his dad.
The ancient Sumerians were Cushites. Now they're in the modern day. A lot of people don't know that ancient Sumerians are modern day Ethiopians.
Ethiopians.
Like Nimrod. You know, Nimrod was Cushite, Ethiopian. The Babylonians are Cushites, they're Ethiopians. Back in the ancient world, their kingdom was massive.
They wasn't just one race like people thought they were.
They had a giant nation. But I'm sure they had other nations.
That's what I meant.
Egypt. Egypt was multicultural. Just like America is multicultural. You know what I'm saying? America's like a modern day Egypt. In the ancient Egypt, you had everybody went to Egypt to learn.
It's just a copy of knowledge. Does it exist? You know what I'm saying? There's certain parts of the earth that have more energy than others.
Oh, we should find that after the summer.
This is so. Washington, D.C., you know what I'm saying? It's different parts of your body that you need. You're not even supposed to get cold. You're supposed to just get hot. You know what I'm saying? But it's just with the diet that we had today, we just sit there and freeze. That's important.
Our people eat swine, that's not because it's plain.
We've been slaves and that's all they was eating.
And what does scripture say about pork?
That's institutionalized.
Like the scripture say you ain't supposed to eat it, you know what I mean?
But do you believe in the Bible?
But didn't I teach you? Yeah, I believe in the Bible, but I don't believe in the way people teach it. I believe the people had intentions when they made it. Saying, if you believe in like word for word, I don't believe in word for word.
Word for word.
That's crazy.
You gotta study, that's
not common sense.
Word for word.
Is this the most accurate when it comes to the history? Like for years, they keep getting proven right. At first they said, the Bible is bullshit because they spoke to the Hittites, but the Hittites don't exist. But then they actually discovered the Hittite kingdom. Archaeology found a cuneiform tablet and all that. And then it's like, oh shit, the Bible is not true. They have a lot of instances like that.
I'm not saying it's not telling the truth. I'm just not saying it's not telling the old
truth.
If you go by what the churches say, they ain't teaching no truth.
This is like this.
Enoch.
You know what I'm saying? Enoch, all they say is about Enoch, he was there, he was gone.
Right.
This man lived for thousands of years.
That was before the flood, too, though. He got beamed up.
I'm going to tell you that right there. That proves that the earth was here way longer than 13,000 years.
But Enoch was a descendant of, the son of Methuselah, wasn't he? His father was Enoch's father Methuselah? He's the oldest man that ever lived.
That's what I'm saying.
We used to live to be old as hell.
If you think they wasn't writing books then, people crazy.
Like even the Sumerians said that
they didn't have technology yet. But man, they had 2013 years. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. This ain't the first time.
How much knowledge?
You didn't have spaceships and stuff. That's where I want to
go. Well, before the flood, there was some bugged out shit.
There wasn't no damn people just jabber-dabber doing this shit. That's what I'm saying. This shit is buried.
Well, you're right. Before the flood, you're right, though, because people was living to be old. If you studying for 800 years straight,
that's when that 13,000 from like what? Renaissance, right? If they can do that within 1,000 years, imagine what somebody can do if they live for
9,000 years.
There's no way this is patty cake.
You're right, though.
And then we dying every day, basically.
But just think about, because if you see what they do, you see what kind of wickedness they do with the technology today, right? Boom. Now imagine what kind of wickedness they did with the technology back then. That's why they had to flood this. The Lord flooded the earth.
That's what I be wanting to talk about.
They was doing all kind of madness.
Wait till it comes out when they release some things out of them. laboratories. The ones they mix with human.
When they kind of
DNA. Ah. Just, oh,
that's
man.
What they don't want to talk
man,
about.
Just wait,
they don't want to talk about. They listen to us talk right now.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
There's going to be a horror story out of these streets when they see shit walking. And no, things, when they come out, they don't gonna be biting.
They know that's what they, when they tell you though from your face. They don't. They tell you you're a predator and all that stuff. You don't think they really walking around that cop to be a shapeshifter or whatever? I'm just playing. You think that if it's not real, you think that today they already got in the military, put a cloak on yourself, and you can't see me.
Yeah, they got some shit. You know what I'm saying?
If
you think somebody can walk past
that
you, that's not what they really look like. You can lost your damn mind.
Yeah, they got some strange shit.
Hey, the real shapeshifters though, the angels from the angels. Yeah. The angels shapeshift from the angels. They come up here. There's a whole thing. I don't know. Well, I mean, that's something you can't teach somebody. They can't understand that, you know.
Yeah,
I mean,
a lot. It makes you, that's what they were trying to tell you in the Matrix.
You talk, yeah.
If your brain can be unlocked or not, some people can't.
Some people
you can set them free, and they don't even, they don't like it.
Because they don't like it. At the end of the day, we can teach people all we want, but at the end of the day, the spirit got to tell us. You gotta see.
I knew them,
but just what they call the so-called third eye, with your spirit.
That's what I like to say.
I say the Holy Spirit.
The average street dude ain't gonna understand that.
Nah, they ain't
gonna understand. All they know that it's dope. And all they know,
I go hard.
But it, you know what I'm saying? The mafia, they knew how to flip that dope, and they got vending machines. Now they got banks. Yeah. They went from, that's what the mafia did not have no way of making money. But they went, they extorted people, they sold dope, and they turned it into business.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But black people in the hood, they don't know how to do that. You know what I'm saying? We put up a stand right now. No, one black people go to it, go right down there in Arabia and buy from them.
Exactly.
We have hot dogs all day.
Yep. Boom. Yeah, swine all over the store. That's your boy. Be careful with that.
You don't want to hear that.
You don't get a ticket. Now we know that guy right now.
So I'll be putting my money up, man. I'll be studying.
It's flat out having understanding.
Come on, why inside your body, how your brain works in your body, how it works with the universe. Like when you cry. Flat out.
As long as he don't talk about the
talk, man. He talks to hate the black woman.
That's our enemy. You might find one that dig you.
That's what
you might. You find, we all found one that dig us for a time being. But that's it. Just for a time being.
Let's just talk about my mom.
And my mom was a hoe. She got multiple children by multiple niggas. My mama, you know, she did a lot of unrighteous things to me while growing up. You know, so our mamas.
You still love her,
you
know, though.
Right, you still, I still love my mom, though.
You talking about but we gotta, in order. You're not talking about that. I'm talking about one.
Okay, let's go to my mama. Let's go to my aunts. Let's talk about my sisters.
That's your family.
Let's talk about my daughter. So, where did we just say the Lord goes to for the kingdom of heaven?
That's not right to say that.
But watch this.
That's his personal.
But what happened?
She's going outside.
You don't talk about the year.
That's what I'm saying.
You know
I'm talking about.
Let's talk about the divorce rate in the so-called black people in America back 50 years ago.
Dig what I'm saying?
90% now.
Knowledge.
It's 90%.
It's higher.
It used to be 90% marriage stayed intact.
Right.
So what it is they... Is the devil don't come through and divide the family? Because our women used to be in order, right? If you was a whore back in the 1950s, the whole neighborhood shamed you.
Boom.
You know what I mean?
Boom.
Now they don't. Now they encourage you. You know, women got tattoos on their breasts. You know what I mean? They wilding
Tramp
out.
Stamp.
They wilding out.
Tramp stamp.
That's because they've been given too much liberty.
Boom.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So that's why. That's why he said that's when they ended the part of it.
Listen to this scripture.
Well, that's what he's talking about. That's
your home.
And they have it, like the Lord said, in the end of the day, because we live in Satan's kingdom, so they had turned your own family against you. They took to their propaganda and mind control. You know what I'm saying?
This is Luke 14:26. Amen. Come to me. Hate not his father, his mother, his wife, his children, his brother, and his sister, yea, and his own life. Also, he cannot be my disciple.
Right, because then your mom. He tried to teach the Bible to figure out
how to read again. He wanted to read again.
Luke 14:26.
Jesus saying
it? Yeah. Luke 14:26. If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife.
Oh, he's telling you to hate his wife, hate your wife.
No, you hate them just like your wicked ways. They do wicked shit. You know, adultery, eating bottomless things.
You know what I'm saying? I want his interpretation.
Things to you.
What do you?
You know, well, just how we do.
I can say, I can take that Bible and tell people what mean what preachers are doing today. No, what I'm saying, you're not, you're just reading it to me.
Well, he can tell
I want your interpretation of what
I'm
saying. Why I'm saying that is a lot of preachers say, this said this, and that said that.
Preachers don't cover the scripture.
Yeah, they don't never read it. They say their interpretation of it.
But they don't cover the scripture. They will not cover the scripture.
They just gonna read John 2:6.
They will not read
the way they want to read to you, say whatever it means. Like,
you're right, though. They do that.
It's about money. It's about coming up. Boom, boom, boom. And that's it.
But you mean, knows that. It's clear what it's talking about, though.
We ain't got no real profit from some of their laws.
No, I just wanted his interpretation.
So, like he was saying, like, when he, because
I can make you think whatever tried, I wanted to think.
So, but do it for us.
Like the Lord, like,
he, that was the purpose.
Tell him about what happened.
I don't know what. He's just reading something. I'm like, what does it mean?
It's returning to the conversation with him. That's what we do. We go in the scriptures and back up every.
And that's why I said to him, so we have interpretation, not interpolation. You know what I'm saying?
Conversation should be. Godly and holy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, so, like, does it mean I should hate my mother, and my brother, and my kids should hate me? Is that what you're trying to say? Like,
no.
That's what I'm saying. I was like, you know, it's clarified. That's not what we're talking about.
So you got the difference when you come to the truth. You learn to love the good and hate evil, and that's what that scripture is saying.
Right. But before that, we was talking about first thing we was talking about. I was like, black woman's God. You was talking about, you supposed to hate. You supposed to hate the one. Humans are our enemy.
But right now, you gotta love her. You're supposed to love her. You know
what I mean?
Well, that's not what we're saying.
But right now, we caught out in this madness out here.
Right.
And then everything's turning against us out here.
That's because he's untrained. You gotta have a trained man.
No, because I'm talking about this kingdom we in, bro.
Oh, the kingdom.
We're in Satan's kingdom right now.
Oh, dude.
And our people are living by his rules. And his liberty, whatever liberty Satan gives them, they take it and run with it. You know what I mean?
Exactly. But if you choose to live by that,
when you turn your back against Satan, our people will hate you for that, bro. And when you like turn your back on this world, and they turn their back on you. You know what I mean?
That's what it means by that.
So and when we teach the truth, we can't be partial to our own family members. So whether, because that's what you call tough love, you know what I mean?
Verse 27. Whosoever does not bear his
cross. The Amish people there, that's what I meant. The Amish people, they ain't doing that. They rich as hell.
The Amish?
Yeah, wherever it was. That people like that. I'm talking Mormons, whatever. People like that. They don't have to.
Well, they Freemasons, though. They're all. Mormons are, that's a
branch. Some of them be witchcraft, if you don't even know about that.
This is Micah 7:2. For the son dishonored the father, the daughter rises up against her mother, the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law.
So they be fighting in the middle of the street for baseball match.
Micah, right?
Listen, let me read 7:6. And a man's enemies are the men of his own house.
I see number fights in everybody's house. Just number wild, people crazy as hell. You know what I mean?
I put up my dude's crib just like a couple years ago, and he went crazy. He shaved off all his hair, he took off all his clothes, he had an axe, he busted every window in the house and everything. You know, he had his whole family hostage in the bathroom upstairs, man. He just flipped out one day, man. You know? And to this day, they still provide for him, and he just used them, don't work, don't do nothing, man. They're scared of him, you know? They're scared of him. And I told him why. I told him too, but, you know. That situation got worse. they've been
But that fixes a lot of things. You got 7 or 8 brothers. Like I said, you got yourself. You know what I mean? You got 7 or 8 brothers. They got a way of living and they stick to it. There's no breaking that. When 2 or 3 brothers come along, there's no breaking that.
Me and my brothers, I got 5 brothers. I got 5 brothers, 4 sisters.
What happens when they become corrupt by the world? And then they come back into your organization and corrupt others. That's how organizations get broken down.
Me and my family used to be like that, man. But now, if they had an opportunity, they'd rob me and kill me.
That's why he's trying to tell you, though, at the end of the day, we ain't gonna have no order. We're gonna rule the earth. We're gonna rule the whole earth. We're gonna be the rulers of the earth. That's the end game, you know what I mean?
That's the end game. That's
It ain't just getting money, it's ruining the whole planet.
When is that supposed to happen? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, bro,
why
only
the
father
sky.
Only
you know
the father knows
the day. I'm like, I'm trying to get me a house now. I'm trying to give you a nice credit now.
Knowledge comes first. Hey, knowledge comes first. Hey, the scripture says first.
I'm tell my kids just read the Bible. You don't have this and that.
Luke 14 and 33.
You gotta get knowledge first.
Luke 14 and 33. So my
job right now.
We got jobs. We all got jobs.
So likewise,
education.
So likewise, whosoever be of you that forsaketh not all that he, so likewise, whosoever he be of you that forsaketh not all that he hath, he cannot be my disciple.
What are you reading that?
But like us coming out here trying to teach brothers, right? Our family come against us for this. They made fun of us. You know what I mean? Your woman can leave you like you raggedy. They call you every name. You wearing that stuff out there on the streets, looking retarded. You know what I mean? And everybody make fun of you. But we come out here teaching people, though. You see what I'm saying? So this is part of denying ourselves, because our flesh, ourselves, we want to go home, get drunk, maybe, you know what I'm saying, play some video games. We ain't doing that. We sacrificing our own life to come do this, to teach our brothers. You know what I mean? We could be doing a lot of other things today. Sunday, the game is on. You know what I mean?
Romans 12 and 1. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of the Most High, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice.
Yeah, that's what we do when we come out here teaching. So we had dudes that earlier 3 months. Where's your boy Sean? He was pregnant. He's like, why y'all talking like that, son? What's up?
Yeah, he's like, you say though, when you talking about, you're talking about getting actual headquarters. That's what the HQ's the spirit, bro. If everybody's on the spiritual, same spiritual vibration, then a lot of them, that's the, they just stop there. I mean, you, because a lot of guys done got buildings, a lot of guys done got communities, they done got communities, and they started businesses, and they get, a lot of our people, and they get corrupt, they get millions, that's what they get corrupt, that's corrupt for the people.
He was created to be a bastard.
That's his job.
Well, we believe in predestination. Everything's predestined.
Yeah.
You know
what I mean? Destiny is what you think. Flat out.
That's not true. That's an illusion.
You talking about faith.
Right.
Destiny and faith is two different
things. We believe in predestination. Everything's been, the script's written. Like the Lord already chose the elect.
If you're saying something that's going to happen, that means it's already happened.
Because I believe in God. You believe in a God, right? I believe that there's a God and He controls everything.
That's not true.
What the fuck
was
that? God, correct. Yeah, but the Lord controls everything, bro. That's what we believe. I believe the Lord controls everything, and it's so bugged out that we can't even understand it. You know what I mean?
I can understand it now. Once you get that out, just all that poison out your system, and all that sick thing out your system, it starts to go away, because it's all about order.
Right, exactly. It's all about
this
order.
This planet is placed in a certain to the point where it can be hot, cold, and every season. Every plant, the moon, and all that.
Yeah, right. Everything's in order.
It's all like, order. Everything.
At the end of the day, it's the Lord that allowed this to happen.
It's the order. It's the order. Yeah. But you got to understand the gravity, all that.
Romans 2, verse 2, it says, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove to which is good and acceptable and perfect with the Most High. You're talking about getting that stuff now. You gotta have patience, you gotta wait. You can't be conformed to this world, because the world will have more control. You know what I'm saying?
So well, we still gotta make
your mom and your dad, great-great-great-dad, but no, too bad. But they wasn't sitting around not cultivating their land.
But we know
they
this.
Wasn't sitting around not learning how to mathematics.
But we know this. We know that, though. We study on
point. What you're saying is, it's like, there's no point.
Black Wall Street got
it. Exactly.
There's no way out
of it. You know why they got no screw? They trusted. They trusted somebody that wasn't
supposed to. I mean, you can make a little
Black
check.
Wall Street,
make
they was armed. You think they would have let that happen?
No.
They wasn't about to let nobody cut off some. They cut off the lines and everything, so they couldn't cut off nobody. They had their own army. That couldn't have happened.
That's the problem.
They had. They had no. This had no
Most
way
I
to do
said
it.
That these
That's
curses.
A good scripture, though.
Most I said that the curse is going to pursue you. It's going to be on you. Fucking.
I got a perfect scripture for you.
You just how it's supposed to be.
What you doing, what I'm saying, you calling a white man Superman.
But check this out. No, yeah.
You know what? You know what? Like you said, man, you running. You got that.
The helicopter?
Don't
nobody believe in the right situation.
They can't get no
what black people.
Right.
Japan, all them, China, they don't care.
Let me read it.
They're not scared.
Let me read something.
Even then, if so, them persons will still chase you and haunt you, even after you sold yourself.
I'm going to show you why it's never going to happen. Jake in the army like that, but let me explain it.
The Caucasians are the most hated race on the
earth. Of course, they are. You know, of course they are.
We the only people that think they so powerful. I really think that shit. Believe it. But we brainwashed to every continent. Australia. It's Australia, Canada, and South America too. Them all, none of them is not indigenous to none of them. They're not indigenous to not one of them. But they all migrated over there too, because they can't be in the fucking sun. You know what I'm saying? It's like, that's what the thought of the vampire came from. There's the one that was fucking true, bringing their baby's blood and shit like that. And witchcraft.
They
was too close.
They Israelites.
They were war race. We're warrior race. I'm looking that up right now.
The Vikings are Israelites. You know the Vikings? Yeah. Those are Israelites. Leif Erikson.
Exactly. They,
all them.
But actually, they go deep into too. They go into the cultures.
They was pagans though. I mean, our people all like, wicked as hell.
But it's all. They all. Like I said, they all come from the Bible. Oh, that's all Israelites.
Let me read the scripture, though. All right, it's a good one, though. It's a good one.
I thought so.
Check this out. This is John 18 and 33. Then Pilate entered into the judgment hall again. This is right before the crucifixion. The Lord said, now with Pilate, and they talking, right? He's about to get handed over to be crucified. Then Pilate entered into the judgment hall again and called Jesus, we know his real name is Yahawashi, and said unto him, art thou the king of the Jews? Yahawashi answered him, sayest thou this thing of thyself, or did others tell it thee of me? Pilate answered, am I a Jew? Thine own nation and the chief priests have delivered thee unto me. What hast thou done? Yahawashi answered. Now check this out. This is what the Lord said. He said, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servants fight, that I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now is my kingdom not from hence. So our people ain't, like you talking about, get an army. That's never going to happen. You know what I mean? Because the Lord's kingdom is not of this world. It's the world that's coming. Hey, if you tell a child that he's stupid every day, what are you going to say?
Stupid.
Exactly.
Somebody
read that 2 Ezra 6:9. Because we ain't going to get paid in this kingdom. This place got to be destroyed. It got to go. Every last brick is.
I'm not saying we gotta be billionaires or nothing like that.
I know, there ain't nothing wrong with getting paid to take care of your family. That's something totally separate. Because in the kingdom.
I'm not talking about just one person getting paid. I'm talking about as a collective group. You know what I'm saying?
In the kingdom, bro, our plates are. We eat off of them made out of gold.
You know what I'm saying?
With his food, my spoon is really gold.
Every time we get together, it do make some money.
Because you know this.
They get demonized by that dollar. That wickedness.
Right.
Stones.
You're not taught that discipline.
Hey, I'm like part of a spirit of that, like down in this world.
And where's that scripture?
You know what I'm saying? I like wearing jewelry.
There's a scripture.
I like having cute shit. You know? That's just me, man. But I know I'm a slave to
somebody. If y'all came down here beating your ass, I'm not going to just sit here and let them beat your ass. My all these other brothers be some motherfucking cowards. Let's do that.
Right. Oh, yeah, we actually brought that up earlier.
You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't. That's just me, though.
I feel you, because you gotta help people. That's what Moses did when he seen his brother get.
And that's why they do it. They think they can do the shit that they doing right
now. Yep. Exactly. You're right, though. You're right.
Do anything about it.
You out, man.
I'll see y'all next time.
All right.
All right, man.
All right, brother.
Yep.
Where your dude earlier, I asked him, he said he seen the cop beat the shit out of somebody. I said, ain't you gonna help him? He said, no. I was like, that's play, bro.
but he go harder than us.
Yep, sure do.
How you doing? We did that. We ended on this one.
Second half was
6-9.
Yeah, started one though, man. That's
yeah,
bad,
you're right,
man. That's bad,
yeah,
man.
You might as well. I mean,
that's bad, man. Told him most
like he couldn't get it. Cause we try to tell him that there's not wrong with making some money on this side, but. Yeah, but in the kingdom, we ain't gonna have no little bullshit ass money, bro. We gonna have golden plates, golden forks. Like in the scriptures, they tell you Solomon, and all of his plates were gold, and none were silver. Like silver was a bad thing. You know what I mean? You know, if your mom got that good silverware, you ain't allowed to touch it, bro. And she proud of that. But Solomon say he had none silver, all gold. So that's the type of riches we talk about. The type of money we talk about getting, man. Land. Actually, that's real wealth. Real wealth is land, resources, cattle, women. You know what I mean?
Fruits, slaves
as well. Servants. We trade in the plants. We had them with the planet market. Look, I trade like marbles or something. I get marbles.
We probably never use the same gold spoon for
it. No, you throw it out. Go melt it down. You got to melt it down and make it again.
Yeah.
That's what he's going to do.
Earth's going to produce gold in the papers.
Yeah, it will.
It's going to produce a lot of gold. You know, they be out there with those big ass machines.
Destroying whole mountains.
Right. Just to get 100 ounces, man.
That's true, though. If you probably, I guarantee you, treating the earth the way she's supposed to be treated, it's gonna heal real more fruit.
That reminds me, man. My favorite show is about to start back up season. Gold Rush. I love
Gold
that
Rush.
Show. Oh man.
They be getting
I'm a geeker to Gold Rush, man. I just love gold, man.
Hey, gold is amazing. Why do you think gold's worth so much? All your computers got gold in it. Have you ever pulled a RAM card? Pull a RAM card out your computer. What do you call those things? The fucking all the little metal pieces all gold on your RAM cards.
That's why they want
the phones
after people don't want it.
The phone? Lithium too.
What?
Lithium batteries. That's a precious element. Whatever you call it. That's a not easy to find.
They gonna burn them phones up and extract the metals out.
Yeah,
that's
what you do. You can take old computers to the junkyard and they melt that shit down. They melt all the Jews own that place too.
Yeah. That's what they don't that's what them Jakes is doing in Ghana. Take TVs
and they
the
melt that shit down.
Burn that shit down. Take all the precious stuff.
That's how you do it.
And there's a video on YouTube of a Jake burning cell phones on taking the metals out of them. He shows you how to do it. There's a video on YouTube how to do it. It'd be a waste of our time, man. We'd never be able to collect enough cell phones.
That'd take a lot, bro.
Yeah.
Because gold is so bad, you can melt gold all the way down to like a fucking hair.
To see through.
So, yeah, and it would still be
translucent.
It'll still be strong. It's one of the most dense metals out there. That's why it's so valuable. You can make the most beautiful art with gold. Hey, read that, Ezra's. Get there, I'm bowling.
I got that 6-1. He said it to me in the beginning. In the beginning, when the earth was made, before the borders of the world stood, wherever the wind blew, before it thundered and lightened, wherever the foundations of the
earth. Oh, sorry. It's Satan there. Satan there. Read that again, man.
Second 6:1. He said to me, in the beginning when the earth was made, before the borders of the world stood, or ever the wind blew, before it thundered and lightened, or ever the foundation of paradise was laid, before the fair flowers of the sea, or ever the moving powers were established, before the innumerable multitude of angels were gathered together.
The innumerable multitude of angels, bro.
There's a horse for
no, not at all.
Wait, you want to give him another?
Huh? No, I used to talk to him back in the day.
No.
That was one of the one-time lonely things.
Oh, it's one of them ones. Nothing wrong with that.
Sorry.
It actually is a lot wrong with that.
Where are you from?
trying to get your number. She's trying to get your number now, bro.
What y'all doing here?
She's the fire.
No, what does this mean? Jesus is the Negro.
It's a part of
it. He don't look black?
That's not him. That's not him. That's not him. That's just the image they gave to us. That's but you know what? I'm usually ignoring them. Just ignoring them. Because we out here to stir up spirits. They keep these people on the floor. That's it. That's it. It's just something for us to do. On the floor. This is what we do when we get bored. We come out here and
surprise.
This is just one of our hobbies. So, that's a check too.
She's out here plotting and scheming. Where'd you come from? Let's guess where she's from.
Oh, I came from South Park.
South Park?
No, South Park. That's over there by Mound and...
Oh, right. Okay. Right.
That's my dad's.
Might have been here in Shelter.
Oh, downtown? Is that your wild now?
No, he wilding out. Trying to take my cigarette when he's trying to bite it.
Oh, so y'all just came from somewhere to spend time together?
No, I just seen it down here.
So, see, this stuff that you heard in front of you go on, this is what?
But he was in the wrong way.
Of course.
You didn't provoke him none?
Maybe a little bit.
Okay.
I ain't got nothing to do with it now. I hate Sundays.
I don't. I look forward to it.
Yeah,
I mean, I'm talking about as far as the bus system. Yeah, I had to go babysit my grandma.
Hey, those are my
stories. I got a 2-year-old. My grandma called me like, getting your daughter ready for church. You shouldn't be here right now.
You going to church?
Like, shit.
Uh-oh. You didn't take your boyfriend to church with you?
Church.
We in church right now. In this church. You know we the real pastors, right?
Are y'all recording me right now?
I don't know.
Was this going to be on,
There was two cameras out here.
Star.
Hell no,
might be a good idea, though. You know how many millions of fools watch that? That's a good way to market.
You upload
it? Yeah. He's up in your feet.
What is this thing y'all wearing?
I'm going to find out. I'm going to find out.
What's this thing y'all wearing?
Curtains.
Curtains?
Like I said,
this is a potato sack.
Like you said, we're out here to get people, to provoke people to talk shit. You know? That's what we're out here for.
They got to take them bed bugs off of
us. Why would you do that?
Oh, yeah. You got fleas, bed bugs.
That's what it's in the show. Vex, come out here and vex me. You know? If a person's no good, he's out murdering people, selling drugs, raping people. You supposed to show him love and talk to him kindly and sweetly and even write him a check. So all the money don't need your money. He's supposed to come out here and heal. And that's what we're doing.
She likes him, gangster.
She likes a taller man. She likes a man.
Let's check out.
Tell me about you.
22.
Take that microchip too. They gonna try to shoot you anyway.
What is that?
The microchip.
They put in people's hands?
Good. Soon if you want to get on the bus, if you want to buy anything at the store, you're going to have a microchip in your brain or in your hand. And they're pushing at it. A lot of people already got it.
That's what I was going to speak about. I found the Dr. Mills. All these people that would have had surgeries or breast, even breast, titty, or breast implants, they were showing microchips in breast implants. People.
All right, this is my bud.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. You know, she's down here fucking everybody. She was trifling. She acted like just fucking that dude once was no big deal. She's like, I only fucking once or something like that.
It's crazy.
Alright, y'all, we gotta get out of here.
Shalom.
Fuck the world, fuck Esau, fuck these goddamn two-third ass niggas that rise up against the Lord, Yahweh, shit, y'all.
Oh, yeah, we put curses on y'all motherfuckers.
That's right.
Yeah, we putting curses on these devils today, bro.
See, we still out here and they gone. We're curses on them.
Hey, that's true.
They got the angels plotting, like, hold on, what we gonna do to these fools? You know?
We had to stand firm, boy.
Yeah, them angels, they don't like them coming against us.
Nah. And everybody see, I mean, you can see how he kept trying to get confirmation from the world. Like, he would say something stupid as hell. And like, don't you agree? And most people would just look at him like he was actually crazy as hell.
I hated him, the dude with the paint, that dude.
That dude with them teardrops.
Yeah, yeah. So that
close means he done killed somebody. Yeah.
Or whatever, so.
And you can tell he had the spirit of Satan on it.
Yeah, yeah.
I just felt Satan out here, bro.
Evil spirits.
Just, they was everywhere. I wonder if that was them dudes back there that was plotting.
You took folks? Nah, that wasn't
them. That wasn't them?
Nah, them girls back there, they were like my age.
They was like Masonic or something?
You know, they were part of something. Yeah. Them motherfuckers were part of something that was back there. Because I saw them closer up when I was going to the street. I could see they was part of something.
Well,
worldly niggas, man. Just a different type of worldly nigga. You know, than them evil demon seeds. Like the scripture says, they're going to... mysterious women will bring forth monsters.
Yeah, we see some monsters today.
Yep, that's right, bro. That's right.
And your boy Tudor was arguing with us about Africa and all that. Looked like he ain't brushed his teeth in goddamn fucking 20 years, bro. Just layers and layers of fucking yellow shit all over his teeth, bro.
Yep.
Just, you know what I mean?
Speaking like a madman.
He's just like, that's an unclean spirit, bro.
We got him, though.
We got him multiple times. And he couldn't even realize it, that he was getting cut.
Drew attention to everybody.
And I was finna bring out that Ipuwer papyrus. If you spell it, look up on Google, type in Ipuwer papyrus. And just read that. It is, the Egyptians recorded the Exodus. Okay, and they tell you about it, and about how the rivers were red with blood. Motherfuckers, sons were dying. The poor people became rich, took all their money. And you know, I mean? It just goes into the Exodus. You know, it's talking about the Exodus.
I want to read something.
Yeah, it's good. We read it on camera before. But I gave up trying to read it to that dude because he was a clown. There's nothing you could. Sometimes when you fucking with these people, you just got to know you can't teach them.
Mm-hmm.
You can't teach them.
Okay.
So all you can do is just give them.
Stay spiritual and just reach.
Stay spiritual, just give them the unbeliever scripture. And don't prove
that.
Nothing
and
to
was
them.
On fire too.
Don't even. Yeah.
They was all quiet.
It was.
It was quiet, man. It was quiet. It's beautiful, man.
All right, then.
Shalom.
Shalom.